find some alternate with somebody, but all I see is purple clouds, there's water, but you cannot drown. Feels like I'm thinking out loud and the mirrors are broke. How can I see with all this purple smoke? And the music's soft and calm now that I'm here, it feels wrong. Hope that you enjoy this song. You roll the dice, now you're on thin ice. Oh, hear the bugs, don't bite. Automatic lullabies, purple clouds in the sky. Welcome to my paradise. There's an aurora sky, I feel it in the air every night. Birds that don't fly, people who can never die. Raindrops when you cry, why am I here? I feel a slight emotion of fear. I'm fearful, yes indeed. That's pretty much all the things I've seen. Paradise, paradise. Paradise, paradise. You roll the dice, now you're in ice. Oh, hear the bugs, don't bite. Automatic lullabies, purple clouds in the sky. Welcome to my paradise.
You've just got it, haven't you?
And I love hearing people write their own material. It was a glimpse as to who you are, and I really like you.
Okay, Heidi.
I'm very impressed by you, I have to tell you. 9 years old, your parents must be super proud of you. I'm proud of you. I hope you're proud of yourself. Very well done. You have a beautiful voice.
Sofia.
I think this season we have so many cool kids.
You're right.
Super cool kids. You're one of them. I love your music. I love you. You're a superstar already. I loved it.
Howie.
For somebody that age, your age, to be standing there so confident. You have the voice. You have the talent. You know, a long time ago, I was 9 years old for almost a year. And I think you're amazing.
You are somebody who has just got a God-given talent. And it's rare.
It really is.
Great things are going to happen for you. I can feel it. Thanks, Leroy. Okay, we're going to vote. Howie.
Yes.
Heidi.
Second yes for me.
Sophia.
Yes.
What do you think I'm going to say?
Yes.
You're right. Four yeses.
My name is Kelsey Jane. I'm 33. I'm from Dallas, Texas, and I currently live in Las Vegas.
Kelsey, so nice to have you here tonight. What are you gonna do?
I am gonna be performing as an aerialist for you guys. Thank you.
Is that why you live in Vegas? Because that's your job?
So my day job, I'm actually nervous to tell you because I know nobody likes to go see them, but
Hi.
I am a dentist. So.
What? I wanted to be a dentist.
No way.
I'm jealous.
One of the main reasons I got into dentistry was because I was pretty shy, very reserved growing up. I had very buck teeth. And so I had orthodontic work done. That gave me a little bit of confidence because you smile more. So that's how I got into dentistry. I wanted to be able to give back to people the way that my orthodontist gave back to me. Dental school is extremely expensive. And so I was trying to figure out how am I gonna be able to have the funds for that. On TV came Miss America, and I saw that it's a scholarship program. So through Miss America, I was able to gain quite a bit of scholarship money. I was able to apply that to my dental school. Around the exact same time that I was accepted into dental school, I had dabbled a little bit into aerial, and I knew that I wanted to do both, to be honest. Dentistry, it's a very stable job financially, but I have another calling that I am super passionate about and I love. So I'd love to just pursue aerial, go for the dream, and hopefully win America's Got Talent.
Do your patients know what you do?
A few of them do, and some of them support me, and they're really excited for me. And
I think that's amazing. Good luck tonight.
Thank you very much.
I bet she's a great dentist. No, I do. Because she looks kind.
Usually dress a little bit more, you know, shiny, a little bit more over the top. It was beautiful and refreshing, and your hair, it was some everything. I wish you were my dentist.
I can be funny.
Howie!
It was amazing, but I keep thinking, if you were my dentist and I didn't know, and then I turned on America's Got Talent, and I go, wait a minute, is that my... That's not my dentist. Do you have those in the office? You should drop into people's mouths. That's better than the gas.
I'll try that.
Love the emotions in your face, too. You were in pain, and you were like, yeah, oozing in it all. It was also a beautiful song. I could have watched you way longer than just 2 minutes.
Yes.
I sometimes find these kind of acts a little bit dull because, and I'll tell you why, most people who do this actually do it every day. So I'm kind of thinking, well, you did it yesterday, you did it today.
This is what you're thinking when you're seeing them?
No, this is the opposite, because this is somebody who doesn't do this. It made it for me so much more interesting.
It makes it more exciting.
Just the thought that yesterday you were torturing people and then today you do that, and it was incredible. I'm gonna say yes.
Thank you.
You get your second yes from me.
Howie,
you have your third yes.
Thank you.
Four yeses.
What is your name?
My name is Nick. I'm from Queensland, Australia.
Wow.
G'day.
What do you do for a living in Australia?
I'm a full-time parent and a part-time author, but ever since I was a little kid, I've always wanted to be the best in the world at something. So tonight, I'm going to try and break a world record.
Oh, my God. So we're going to see a world record right now.
We're going to try very hard.
This is the season to do it. Break a record.
Allow me to just go and prepare.
All right.
He didn't have shoes. I think he's gonna be a contortionist.
No, he's what? Going to do a world record.
Of what?
Maybe he's gonna smell everyone's feet.
No.
Wait.
Where did you come up with these horrible things?
What is that?
I don't know, it looks like a flag. I think it's a flag. Right?
Is that a flag? I have no idea what's going on.
It's a flag.
A world record with a flag. Oh, there's the Guinness guy.
So the world record that I'm going to be attempting today is most underpants pulled on in 30 seconds.
The existing record is how many?
The existing record is 23, so if I hit 24, that's a good sign, and that's signified by a gold pair of underpants. So that's what we're hoping for.
So we are going for the gold in the year of the Olympics.
We're going for gold.
Here's what I'm looking for. So they have to be put on one at a time, no leggings to assist with pulling them on, and they need to be fully up. The waistband needs to be at the waist level to count.
Just out of interest, do you think this act could win America's Got Talent this year?
Look, I think I've got a serious chance.
Okay. Let's go.
Well, he's starting there, he's starting over there.
No, I think he's straightening, he's getting it all adjusted.
He's doing all of them?
Well, you don't want them bunching up, you don't want to chafe.
He's come from Australia to do this.
Nick, are you ready? Okay.
Here we go.
We'll start on my go. For the record, 3, 2, 1, go.
Nick, you did not beat the world record, but we have a chance to go for another world record right now, correct?
Correct, yes. So there is a record for most people gathered in one place wearing underwear on their heads.
Why?
If everybody in this room did it, we would end up in the Guinness
Book. You would be Guinness World Records title holder.
Yeah. Would you be down with doing that?
Okay, guys.
I'll put on underwear like never before.
Everyone, you have a pair of underwear underneath your seat. If you would like to participate, please take the underwear, put it on your head.
Okay. Does everyone have their underwear?
We have our underwear. Everybody wearing their underwear.
Okay.
Look behind you. Looks like a non-convention. Okay.
Now, to be clear, if 10% or more of you do not participate, the entire attempt is unsuccessful.
Wow.
So the underwear must remain on your head for the full minute.
So everybody.
Everybody, please keep it on your head or you will be deducted. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Start the minute.
Yes! We got on our underwear, y'all! Let me see you. Proudly wear your underwear. I see you.
Looks like great participation so far.
We got great participation.
30 seconds left. 30 seconds.
27 seconds, y'all.
Come on. left. 15 seconds.
You got your underwear on. You're gonna set a record.
10 seconds.
We got 5 seconds.
4, 3, 2, 1. Yes!
Yes! Michael, Guinness World Records adjudicator, did we break a new world record?
So the mark to beat was 355, and there were some deductions in the crowd. However, today at America's Got Talent, you had 1,206 people.
AGT has just set a new world record! You guys are part of history! All right, we got it, y'all! Yeah, come on out here!
Wow! Congratulations to everybody, but you know, it's all about you right now. Sofia?
I mean, I understand that a lot of people are very, very fascinated about those records. I, for some reason, I don't really care about seeing them happen. So, I didn't love it.
Simon.
Well, he failed on the first one, succeeded on the second one, but it didn't feel that it was very difficult to break that record, if I'm being honest with you.
All right, Heidi?
I mean, we definitely have not had an act quite like this before, but I feel like for all of us to put underwear on our heads is not a talent. It's a no from me.
It's a no from me.
I'm afraid I'm gonna have to say no.
Four no's. Sorry, but thank you so much, and thank you for sharing this record.
It's been a lot to you, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could tell. Okay, Heidi.
You had me right at the beginning when you went, You really do belong on the stage. My favorite audition of the day today, by far.
Wow. Howie.
I think that you have an amazing instrument. Your voice is really good. You're a really good singer. And I think you have a future ahead of you. I really liked it.
The way you sing, the feeling that you put into the song, it's spectacular.
For you to manage what you're doing with a job to do something you love is incredible, actually. What I would say, Brooke, if you go further, I would definitely have a band behind you, because you're the kind of artist who I think would be best where you don't have the structure of a backing track.
Yep.
And I really like you as a person.
Okay, Howie. Yes. Heidi.
Definite yes for me.
Sofia.
I think you deserve a yes.
I think you deserve four yeses. Congratulations.
It was nerve-wracking, and I think you made the right choice by coming to AGT.
Yeah. Thank you.
It was dangerous and scary, and our hearts were beating out of our chests, and that's what you want from a performance. She stood up. I think the German judge gave you a 10.
I did give you a 10 with this. I think I said wow and oh so many times during your whole 2 minutes because it was so incredible. You just kept it coming, one amazing move after the next. It was a show.
This kind of act is one of the most difficult and one of the most dangerous.
I think going forward, my advice would be there has to be a progression. But
you're very, very talented.
Thank you so much.
We're going to vote. I'm going to give you your first yes. Howie.
I'm going to give you your second C.
Thank you. Thank you.
Three C's.
Thank you.
That's four yeses.
Thank you, Emo.
Thank you.
I'm going to need two people to prove my magical powers, but I'm going to need Heidi and Sofia. Can you join me on stage? Excellent. Heidi, if you could just stand right over here for me, that'd be fantastic. We're going to do a trick that uses cheese. I know she's thinking another cheese trick. All right. All right, Heidi, we have like 20 or so slices. You can hold on to the whole stack for me just like that. You're gonna count 10 slices into my hand, one at a time. Everyone here will count with you. Here we go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Give Heidi a big round of applause. Nicely done, yes. Take a bow for the people, they love you. You can hand the rest of the cheese over to Sophia. She's gonna hold on to those. You can just place the cheese on yourself, a secret location.
Hide them, Heidi. Oh, okay. I know.
Thanks for the help. All right, this is oh my. Sophia, same thing. 10 slices in the hand, one at a time. Everyone will count with you. We're just gonna count 10 out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Give Sophia a big round of applause as well. Take a bow. They love you. I do need something from the audience. I need a number between 1 and 5. Someone yell the number between 1 and 5. I heard 2. Oh, 7. All right, wow. Somebody else was homeschooled. Okay, we're gonna go with 2. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna attempt to move 2 slices from Heidi's pile magically, invisibly through the air, and make them land into Sophia's pile. And I'm gonna do that with the aid of this magic wand. That's 1. All right. That one's faster, don't worry, Sophia. All right, Heidi, take the cheese out of your secret location. Oh my. Some of them are turning into fondue. It's okay. Here, count on the hand one at a time, let's see how we did.
Oh, there's more.
Here, count on the hand one at a time, let's see how we did. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sophia, same thing. Take the cheese out of your secret location.
Oh, you guys used the same one.
Here we go. You got them all? You're gonna count on the hand one at a time. Let's see how we did. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Thank you so much, ladies. You can have a seat. Thank you so much. Thank you. Have a seat.
Oh!
Thank you, Haley. Haley, were you self-taught?
For the most part, yes. It took years to get to that level.
I thought it was beautiful. I thought it's beautiful how you look. I saw things that were really dangerous and had stopped my heart. And that's sometimes what I'm looking for in these kind of acts.
Thank you so much.
I really felt that you were fighting for a spot here right now. You piled in everything you could, you know? I mean, it was incredible.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you. And yes, I am fighting for a spot here. Everyone is trying their hardest.
Yeah.
The speed that you garnered at the end was real fast, but it didn't make me go, wow. I think you're very good.
Hold on. So with that, can I ask what you believed it was missing?
What I saw was a very efficient athlete doing what she's supposed to do, and you did your job, but it wasn't for me. I didn't get three or four wows that are worth $1 million.
Howie's totally wrong. Howie's totally wrong.
Okay, we're gonna vote. Heidi.
It was wow for me, so you definitely have a yes.
Thank you.
You have another yes for me.
For me, it's a no.
Good answer!
Haley, what I would say is, don't turn up looking like you're in a circus. It's almost like who you are as a person, I think we're more interested in, as well as your act. However, because technically you were very good, I'm going to say yes.
Thank you.
Six dogs, three cats, two sugar gliders, a serval cat, a Siberian lynx,
whoa,
23 trained rats, two horses, and a donkey. I'm single.
Go figure.
That was good.
Lately, I've been, doing some older women things, like trying to needlepoint and stuff like that. And I'm learning a lot with my friends at the library. But I have not figured out that internet. But I did learn a few things. Like, you should never start a Google search with the first two words, 9 inches. No. That predictive text takes over. It didn't even know me, and it decided what I was going to say next. And now I have seen things that I cannot unsee. Oh, yeah, and it follows you around. All your ads change. And then, like the other day on Facebook, there was this ad for an adult coloring book.
A what?
Now, listen, I'm an innocent person, and I like to color. Oh. So I clicked on it.
Oh, no.
You don't want to color that. I almost wasn't single anymore.
You're very, very likable, I have to say. Oh. And you made us laugh. You were very, very funny.
Thank you.
What I love about you is your freshness. I love that you're not that experienced. You're genuine, you're authentic, you really are likable.
I agree.
And your material is your everyday life.
I mean, you were so funny. But you felt at ease, and you felt like we know you from somewhere. You feel like a nice friend that you would have a great time. I really liked it.
You know what? You're real. And that's what makes it so funny. I thought you were going to be really sweet. After all the animal stories, and then you talk about you-know-what.
I know.
Corkey, I'm gonna kick this voting off with a yes.
Second yes.
Three yeses! Oh my God!
You just got yourself four yeses.
Thank you, Corkey!
Japan!
I don't even know what that was.